Hello and welcome to another painting video. Today, well, what's it called? LVO is upon us, and my brother has an Argonaut army that needs to be painted, and it hasn't even been painted yet. So, today I'm going to kind of explore some colors and get an idea of how we're going to paint this army for him. I have an idea of what he kind of wants, so we're just going to kind of take it from there. So first of all, let's start with a purpley red for the cloth. So we'll do Sigwald Burgundy for that. I know the kind of paint that he's going for, so we'll see if this works out. So let's get the cloth. Trying to be careful of all the nooks and crannies here. Trying to be very clean with our applications. Now doing this is just gonna get us kind of our blocking of the colors for the heroes that he has in his army, but it's not going to do anything for the frigates and stuff, the dirigibles in his army. So that's going to be another problem that we'll have to deal with, but we'll deal with it when we get there. Let's get here, getting his little Arknaut pants. And you can be like, oh yeah, this is kind of like the purple that's on like the default color of them, maybe? Kind of looks like it. And then, oh. Let's do that. Hold on 1 second. Let me. Okay. And I think that's all of the cloth. So now, let's go for the armor, and he wants kind of a blue here. So we're gonna get this Talisar blue, because it's like the bluest blue that I have. I think he wants ultramarine, but I don't have that one. So we'll get the armor panels to be blue, but then we'll do some highlights and stuff over them to bring in our other color. So let's get the armor here. Little harness. It's up to here, this piece right here on the armor. So we gotta get in there. Same thing here. Get that. And then get this. little ring here. And we gotta work to the back of the armor here. Yeah, sorry about the view right now. It's just, you know, we gotta get all these little sections. Some of it's hard to get into frame, so just bear with me for a second. Let me get the shoe here. Cool. Now for this, I think we're gonna go for more like traditional colors and such in there. Okay. So let's actually really quick go back to our burgundy. And just get this little top part on the helmet right here. I think it'll be good with all the rest of the colors that we're using to pop this into here. Is that a bear? No, I don't think they have bear faces anywhere on here. Okay, now for the gun, we're gonna go with like a Space Wolf's gray contrast. It's like a blue gray, and it's gonna kind of help tie in some more of these colors and stuff. So we're gonna use this on like this whole the little clip and everything, and this looks weird. I need to shake it more. I think I need to shake it a lot more. Stand by. Oh yeah, it needs to be shaken. So hold on, let me get some of this. Let's dab this off because I don't know what it's gonna do when it dries. And also, hold on, where's our blue? Tell us our blue here. They have the elbow pads that we missed, so let's. Okay, that's part of that. And he doesn't have an elbow pad there. Okay, never mind. Never mind. So we're gonna keep shaking the crud out of this guy. Like there's a bunch of like white stuff at the bottom here, and you wanna get that out. You wanna make sure that that's not there in your paint. Now I've shaken it pretty thoroughly. Let's see what happens now. It's still kind of the same. Okay, well, we'll just deal with it for now. And we'll fix it as needed later. Sorry. Just getting all the parts of this guy. Little handles here. I want all those. Just clean up that little area right there, soak it up. And then get this guy too. It's like making bubbly noises. Never had that happen before with contrast paint. Interesting. That, and that's just a strap, okay. Okay. And then on the backpack here, let's get some of this stuff with this color as well, just to help tie it all together. We're just picking out a couple like metal-y pieces to use for this, because then the rest of this will be like a metal color. And maybe like this guy here. Maybe not, because of the paint that's on it. Okay, so now we're gonna let this sit and dry so that we can get in with our regular paints to finish the rest of it off. So we'll see you in a little bit. Okay, should be sufficiently dry now. The one thing I did do is I went in and I painted the face blue also. So now let's get in with our paints and start picking out some of these areas. So we're gonna get in here and paint some. We're gonna get our brassy brass, our normal brass color that of course we're running out of, and I should always remember to refill it, but I never do. Okay, so let's start with this piece right here. You definitely want this to be our bronze color. We're just getting mostly, right now we're getting our main colors, our main three colors, which are this purple, the blue, and the brown. Those are our main colors that we're going for this. Oop, I missed some spots here. Using the wrong brush. This is like my contrast brush. I shouldn't be using that. Okay. Just go through here, make sure that's good. We're gonna hit this bit here. And let's go over on this side. Let's get this guy here. probably some of these tubes as well. Just want to add some variations to what we have going on here. We'll get like the little nozzle-y guy here at the end. And then we'll get like this little microphone-y bit here. The end of this. And there's like this piece here. Okay, let's go through and get most of this painted. And we'll go over all those other parts later, don't worry about it. Like the straps and stuff. Right now we're getting this coated. Just keep working through this backpack here. Get all of it. Except this piece because we painted it blue. But we'll be picking out some copper spots on it. Gotta get in there. Okay. Now let's work on the straps here. Let's get our leather brown. Strappies and our. She would probably have to do something, a couple things actually. First, let's do this. Let's get our German camo beige World War II for the gloves, just because, like, we don't want to just slop on a whole bunch of brown in there, because the gloves and the straps will be different colors. So, with our beige color, we'll just go in there and then get our gloves. same thing here. Switch to our smaller brush just to avoid as much messes as we can, and to keep this as clean as we can get it. Same thing here, these little straps here. We also have to get the backs of them and stuff, so just go in here, get right there. Get the insides there. Doesn't have a belt or anything, so that's good. Now we just got these straps up here. Okay, now we can do some gunmetal to kind of help the bronze pop out a little bit more, so it's just not just flat bronze. Which you can do flat bronze if you want, but for us, gonna just call out a couple pieces here and there, like this little knob here. He's also got like a little thingy there. We'll paint this trigger because I got some of the brown on it. Okay, and then we're gonna go in here. We're just gonna kind of call out pieces here and there with this. So like this tube maybe, and the top of this. We're just breaking up those shapes so that it's not just one boring color. Same thing here, so like there's like a grate right here, so let's just paint that. For this, let's just get the little kind of thing that it's in, the little straps on it. For here, we'll just get those, these little bobs and ends here. We'll get this little tube that goes into this piece, along with like this strap here. Let's see here. We'll get like that little nut. We'll get this whole piece right here. Get the little gauge in there. And make sure we just go around here and get the fronts of those things that we tagged. So like a little thing there. Okay. Now, that's all of our gunmetal. So let's go back into our brass color and get some of the details on the armor with this bronze, so with this brass color. So we'll get here, that guy. Get like this little thing here, these little nuts that are on here. Probably we'll get this as well, just to add all of our colors on the head more. And then there's like these little pieces on the shoes that we'll get. Now we gotta get our tubes. For that, we'll get a black gray. It's a good dark color for these types of things. So all our hoses will be this color. So get that. Then we'll start here with this one. Same thing here with this one. These pieces don't need to necessarily stand out. They just need to be painted. So we just pick a dark color to subdue them into the back. There's that. And we got this big hose here. Use a bigger brush for that. We don't need to use this little brush anymore for that. We have the coverage that we can get here with the bigger brush. Okay, so now we gotta do some washes and some other details. So first, let's get the eyes. For the eyes, we're gonna do probably a white color. I think that's probably the better choice here. So let's just get that. Let's get our little magnifying glasses going on here, so that I can see. I gotta repoint this. What happened there? Alright, just gotta get this nice and pointy. Okay. white paint. Clean that up, obviously. Let me just kind of move that into here. It's good because it's contrast paint. I can just take the contrast again and then get that over there perfectly. So let's do our washes. So for the bronze, we're going to be using a Reikland flesh shade. Oops. This will kind of bronzen up our bronze, make it shine a bit, as well as kind of help it pop a little bit more. Let's just kind of touch those areas. Doesn't need to go all up on there. Get that piece in there. This guy. Just gotta go through those little areas that you hit and make sure you get them. And we'll shine them up. Just take this through the whole thing, get it all nice and covered. If we hit the brown with it, the gunmetal color, it's fine. It's gonna rust it up a little bit, which is totally fine by me. Get it there, get that all nice and shaded. Cool. Now let's get our brown wash with Agrax Earth Shade right here. And we'll get the gloves. And like the strappy bits here. That's gonna help those guys pop our detail and stuff for us. There we go. Same thing on this side. And then let's get our blue again, our blue contrast paint, just to fix the eye area and then the part on the face that we missed here. And then we'll call it here. So there we go. Let me get right here too. All right, well, as always, thanks for watching. Like, comment, and subscribe. And we'll catch you guys on the next one.